Welcome to Las Vegas Magic, friends. I'm your host, Eben. Today we're taking a trip down to Fremont Street to see Bernard. What you're seeing is Bernard. He is a no-kill animal shelter gentleman that raises donations for his facility, which I've personally seen it. And over the years, I've always had a chance to hang out with Bernie. Very open gentleman. He's always honest with me. And, you know, I learned from him with the way he flatters people. And he tells, you know, the gentleman, hey, you know, do you have the right to have such a beautiful woman on your arm? You know, and so he laughs and she laughs. And, you know, it's a really, really cute, playful experience. And then he gives them free things like fans, and he gives his brochure on his help animal shelter with cats and dogs, which is out in the North Las Vegas area. And he's got a big house of about 30, 40 cats. What does he have? Like 20, 30 dogs, which I've personally seen. And yeah, he's been doing this since I got here in 2011. August 30th is when I started on Fremont Street, 2011, August 30th. And I loved doing close-up magic on Fremont. And Bernard here, which his name is, we call him Bernie, he has always helped a lot of different people get out and talk with people, like the woman that's standing to the left of him. That's his person that he's guiding. He actually is teaching her how to share the no-kill animal shelter. So he gives people of all different, you know, life backgrounds, he gives them an opportunity to get out and learn how to talk to people. And one time, Bernie let me try it, and I enjoyed it. You know, it definitely wasn't for me doing the pitch, but it definitely gave me the ability to talk to people about animals and give them a chance. So now they're going to move on. And some people donate, some people don't. And Fremont has, you know, all different characters from all over the world. And everyone's totally different. Some people, you know, talk to him, some people don't. You know, it's an interesting paradigm of the way he intercepts people like this. And, you know, he flatters him and says, hey, didn't you see the sign back there? Do you have a license to have a woman like this on your arm? You know, so he gets him cackling. And, you know, it's just really funny to see Bernie do his thing. And, you know, Fremont's made up of all different people, from people that are, you know, entertaining to people that are raising donations to showgirls. And I've had the opportunity to meet all the types. And everyone's totally different. You know, there is no perfect person that does Fremont. And so now, Bernie.
Right, we're going to go in and talk to good old Berno. We're going to see what the word of the day is from Bernie.
Used to see Bernie every night down here in Fremont when I used to do magic. It was so cool to spend time around Bernie. And he was just such a great performer. He really loves doing what he does. He does a no-kill, no-thrill animal shelter, keeping people happy. It's just beautiful.
This cool Las Vegas air away from this beautiful lady to keep her warm and cuddly and happy and loving, but especially hot, and I mean red hot, and smoking hot all day and all evening long. And this is yours to take home as a souvenir to give to somebody that you love. Is he with you?
No.
And this one is yours.
it going, Bernie?
Thank you.
How you been?
Pretty good, yeah. I have to call you. My son is practicing magic.
Awesome.
He's doing practicing magic.
I love it.
Yeah. So how are you? Are you doing well?
Really good.
Excellent.
I always used to do magic with Bernie back 11 years ago. Bernie was here performing.
I'm still performing.
Yep.
Still doing, working out, doing the right things.
Yep.
If you remember four rules, that's all you have to remember to have a great life.
All right.
If you break any one of those four rules, pain is guaranteed down the road. What are they? First of all, you have to learn to eat right. I'm a vegan. Number two, you have to exercise, but you have to exercise every day. Every part of your body, from your head, top of your head, down to your toes. Every part of your body. Number three, you can't get involved with any addictions. Gambling, whether it be drinking or smoking or anything, even personal relationships that gonna bring you down. You have to live a calm and serene life. And four, you have to learn to fast regularly. I usually fast for 24 to 48 hours. Twice or three times a week.
Wow.
Now, if you do those four things, you can live a life without pain.
Wow.
Most people my age are either down there or live with pain. One person, I swear, I have no pain.
Wow.
And I'm going to be 87 years old on June 14th. Of this year, you know, but that's how life should be, without pain. And most people are guaranteed to either, hey, I'll give you a statistic, by the year 2030, over 60% of everyone over 60 years old be suffering with dementia. 60%.
Just a couple of years.
That's right. They'll be walking around like zombies. That's right. Like zombies.
Yeah.
Now, what I'm trying to say, how do you think they, when I was a small kid, maybe 1% of the population had dementia.
Oh,
it was almost unheard of.
That's crazy.
This was in the 40s and the early 50s, only 1%. But now, why do you think they have it now?
Because of the sugar and less exercise.
No, it's basically because of eating meat and dairy. If you look, if you Google Alzheimer's disease and mad cow disease, it's the same thing. You have a herd of 1,000 cows. One of them, you find out, has mad cow disease. Are you gonna slaughter all your herd, or are you just gonna try to kill one or two of them, the ones, and let all the others go? The other ones also have mad cow. They caught it.
Yep.
And you eat the meat and the dairy from them. Mad cow disease.
Holy crap.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Would you slaughter your whole herd?
No way. They want to save every dollar.
And be bankrupt?
No
be,
way.
Come get bankrupt?
They're not going to start over again. No way. They're going to keep all the money coming.
They need to live.
Yep.
And nobody understands it, so they don't do nothing.
Yep.
You're supposed to slaughter your whole herd.
That's the rule. Got it.
What can I tell you? The thing that you do the best, try to expand it to another level. Put in the effort. Even go to school to learn even new tricks, new ways. Now, the most important thing for you, imagine, my son has a great mind, memory. He can remember.
Wow.
That's why he knows languages, Japanese and Korean, and he's going to be studying Mandarin Chinese. And he writes it, and he reads it. So how did he do that? By try to read a book, get a memory book.
I got the aerial book. I bought it. I already read it.
Isn't that, has it helped you?
Yeah.
That's what helped you.
Yeah.
Memory is so important. Without memory, you're fucked in this world. You know things, you can do things that other people can't do.
Yeah.
That's it. That's the tricks of life. Keep it short, simple, and stupid.
I love it. Thanks, Bernie.
Sure.
We'll see you.
I'll see you again.
We'll see you here downtown on Fremont.
See ya.
Lots of great entertainers down here.
Right. I got your number. I'll call you.
Yep.
I'm going into something that you'd be interested in.
All right. Check out this video right here in the middle.
Right.
And give it a thumbs up and let me know. Leave in the comment, what's your favorite advice that Bernie gave us?
Tell us the best advice is make life short, simple, and stupid.
I love it.
That's it. Keep it simple.
Yeah.
Don't get involved with things that are difficult where you're all fucked up, you don't know where you're going.
Yep. See ya.